Brenda.
I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm kind of glad she's not here because I need to talk to you.
Okay, I'm not Jason. I'm not going to let you just walk in here whenever you feel like it, so just...
This can't wait, Sonny, and it's
okay, I'm not interested in what you have to say because, look, Brenda already told me you're threatening to ruin the wedding. And I don't know how many times I got to tell you or how
I got... Okay, look, this has nothing to do with Brenda. This is about our son. Michael was raped in prison. He didn't want to admit it. He thought it'd be easier on us if we didn't know. It's Michael, you know. He'd rather carry the pain around himself than admit to us he was attacked.
Who was it?
That doesn't matter.
It matters to me. Because I'm going to put a bullet in the son of a bitch's head.
Jason already killed him in prison.
Carter? How long has Jason known?
Michael didn't admit this to anybody till last night. I don't know if he ever would if Abby hadn't been attacked. Michael found Abby last night in an alley, and her ex-boyfriend had beaten her up, and he was trying to rape her, and I guess the whole situation just... I don't know. Michael went straight to Jason, and he told him everything.
I just, you know, everything that my son has been through because of me is just not right.
Because of you. If you want to blame anyone, then you point the finger at your firstborn. Because if it weren't for Dante, Michael wouldn't be in prison to begin with. Michael has suffered unspeakable pain, all because Dante had to take the moral high ground. Meanwhile, he had no problem burying a body for Brenda.
Dante didn't know that Michael was going to be sent to prison.
That doesn't change what happened to Michael or the fact he's going to be carrying this around for the rest
of
his life.
You're angry. I'm angry, too. But taking it out on Dante is not going to help Michael through this.
He's agreed to go to counseling. That's why I'm here. He needs your support.
I'll be there for him. Whatever he needs, I'm there.
Then please don't marry Brenda right now.
I don't want to go talk about this right now. Look, I love Brenda. I'm going to marry her. That's that.
All the love in the world isn't going to stop her from hurting you.
Okay, I'm not listening right now to any of this
stuff.
Not listening. I just can't.
Okay, well, you know what? You need to listen to this, though. Because every time you get hurt, you go to that dark, ugly place, and it takes everything Jason and I have to pull you out. Only this time, we won't be able to. See, all of our energy is going to be focused on Michael and getting him out of the hell he's been living. And Michael doesn't just need Jason and me. He needs his father. So, you know, right now would be a really bad time for Brenda to push you into a breakdown.
I just went to the bakery with Max because I guess, you know, people, you know, test wedding cakes, so we're supposed to make a decision about our wedding cake tonight. Are you okay?
Carly was here.
Of course she was.
She wanted to talk to me about Michael. He's going through a rough time right now.
Is there something I can do?
Show me the option of cakes.
There's chocolate and double chocolate.
Mm.
And dark chocolate. Chocolate mint chip.
Yeah.
Brenda's not here.
Yeah, well, her wedding dresses, which is no small feat considering the absurd amount of time I was given to pull this wedding together, and the fact that Brenda has a dress, let alone a custom-made one, is a miracle in and of itself.
I'll let her know.
Oh, no, no. I had to call in several favors to make this dress happen. I'm not just going to hand it to you.
I don't know when Brenda's going to be back.
Then I'll leave it in her room.
Well, apparently it was my duty to inform you that your wedding dress had arrived. It is my duty as the, the executive vice president in charge of bridal affairs to help you try it on. Yes.
What? That's what she said to you?
Yes.
I don't even know what that means.
Well, I want to help you try it on. Come on. She said she put it in your room. What? You're not coming?
Yeah, I just, I'm going to try it on later.
Are you joking? You've spent weeks trying to pick out the most perfect wedding dress and now you don't want to see it? Who are you and what have you done with my best friend?
Well, it's not about the dress, right? It's about the marriage. All right, it's about the dress. But I'm just, look, to be really honest, I am suddenly having a hard time getting excited about my own wedding because I just know that Carly is doing everything in her power to try to ruin it. It's making me nervous.
I knew she was gonna try and do something. What does she do now?
Well, every time I'm here, first of all, that woman comes barging in this front door lately and she thinks she owns the place. And by the way, she thinks she owns Jason too. You realize that, right?
Yes.
And you know how Sunny and I bought that beautiful place out in the woods and it's supposed to be our place where we can escape and get away from the craziness?
She,
to be honest, Carly's craziness.
Showed up there?
Yeah, she showed up there and told Sunny, you know, that she needed to talk about Michael.
Of course. I mean, that shouldn't be a surprise to you. She always uses the Michael card as leverage. I mean, she uses her kids all the time to get to Sunny. I mean, that's how she stalks him.
What happened to that woman? Why is she so sad and pathetic?
I don't know, but that's exactly the way I would describe Carly.
Michael here. I need to see him.
He's not here right now.
My son was raped in prison. You think his mother would keep something like that from me?
So what are you waiting for? Let's just get this over with. I put Michael in Bentonville. I trapped him like a rat, made him easy prey for a guy like Carter.
There's nothing on this earth worse than watching the people you love suffer for the choices you made. You suffered because of my choices. Now, Michael's suffering because of the choices that we made.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what to do. I want to give him some peace. I don't know how to do that.
I don't have an answer. I mean, this is just the worst thing that, you know. I don't even know how I'm going to begin to help him, whatever, I don't know.
You told him?
I know that when I marry Sunny, I'm going to have to promise to deal with all of the baggage that comes along with him, but...
I know, but Carly is not your run-of-the-mill baggage. She can't be alone, you know? And I think that's why she holds on so tightly to the kids, because it's the only thing that she can still hold over Sunny.
Yeah. Well, I guess the good news is that, you know, Michael and Morgan are almost grown up, so she won't be able to hold them over his head for much longer, but I do feel bad for Jax. He has years of the insanity that is Carly coming to him.
Can we not talk about her anymore?
Okay.
I really, really want to see your dress. Please.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. That's pretty good.
I
This is going to be the most beautiful.
Oh my God. Oh my God.